Do you want to know how you really come up with invention ideas? The thing that separates a real inventor from somebody that just has ideas is that an inventor knows how to identify a market and then build products that will sell. And you can do this too. So I've talked a lot about this, the difference between an idea person and somebody that's really an inventor. We all have ideas. We all have great ideas that are the next billion-dollar opportunity. But the problem is, you need to make that idea a reality. If you don't even try, you'll never find out if it truly is that billion-dollar idea. The only good ideas are the ones that we turn into a reality. So the next problem that inventors face is this idea that somebody's going to come along and steal their idea and make all kinds of money first before they get a chance, you know, to sell their invention. This is so unrealistic. I cannot tell you how many times I have heard this, and I just see it as an excuse for you not to start working and turn your idea into a reality. If you're that worried about the idea being copied, then go out and patent it if it makes you feel better. Go get a design patent, go get a utility patent, or whatever protects you. Go see a lawyer, pay all those fees, but at least you'll be able to sleep at night. I hope that these videos are helping you to understand what it takes to be an inventor. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that notification bell, give me a thumbs up, and leave lots of comments below. But the thing that I do, I just take my idea, turn it into a product, and start selling it. By the time somebody has copied my idea, I've already made my money and I'm moving on. And that's the way you should think of it too. What you really need to do here is release yourself from the idea. The idea is just the catalyst to begin you on your journey. Don't worry about what may or may not happen. Just take the steps that are appropriate to protect your idea and to start selling it. Now, the ideas that we want to come up with, we want to come up with things that people are either going to enjoy using or that solve a problem. And you've heard this before, but I'm not a real believer in the whole it needs to solve a problem. There are a million different reasons people buy things in this day and age. The market around the world has changed completely over the years because of the internet. We're no longer limited to just a few items in our local stores that we can pick off the shelves, buy and go home and play with or use or whatever. Now we have just billions, literally, of products available to us on websites all over the world. If I want to buy something that's made in Germany, there's German websites that'll ship here to the US. If I want to buy something that's made in another part of the United States, I get on Amazon and I look for something. The world is now open to us. And that's the fundamental thing that the internet has changed. So when you're thinking of your ideas, you know, I've talked about this before. We're thinking about ideas that we can sell on the internet. That's really our first step. We may go retail, we may go to resellers, but what if that product only has a limited market? Well, on the internet, that market might be big enough for you to make the kind of money we've been talking about in previous episodes. Just because a market is small doesn't mean that there aren't enough people to buy your items. And that's what's so exciting about the unlimited possibilities of all the ideas that you can come up with. I've talked about this a million times. You need to research the market. You need to see what other products are out there, how much they're selling for, the way they're built, how much you think they cost to make. But you also need to look for opportunities where there are no products, where you can build a product in that marketplace that's different than everything else that people may want to buy. Now, here's the sad reality of life. You could literally come up with an idea, create the prototype, and then make the products, 100 pieces, remember we always talk about that. So you make your 100 pieces, and then nothing happens no matter how hard you try to sell. But I promise you this, even if you fail on your first invention, you will learn so much that even the second, the third, the fourth, or maybe the fifth will become your big idea, your big invention. I know that's frustrating to hear, that it may not happen out the gate, but that's life. And think of all the things that you'll learn along the way. Even if you lose a few thousand dollars, and yes, I have talked about this in previous videos, your first invention should only cost a few thousand dollars to make. You'll still learn quite a lot in the process. Imagine how much easier that second product will be for you to build. And that's what this process is all about. It's about the journey. It's about learning. It's about knowing when you see an opportunity that you can create things to fill a market. That's what the ideas of an inventor are. When Thomas Edison started, he invented the light bulb. But that was just the beginning, because once he invented the light bulb, they then had to figure out how to make electricity and then send it down the wires to the households. Now, if you look at the history of Edison Electric, it's quite interesting, and it took many years for that infrastructure to be built. That what could be nowadays considered a simple idea, the invention of the light bulb, created an entire industry. Here in California, many of our buildings that generate electricity still say Edison Electric on it, and Edison Electric is still in business here. So just the idea of a light bulb turned into billions and billions, if not trillions of dollars over their lifetime. And that's the way you need to think. Start with your little ideas, invest a little bit of money, identify a market, invent a product for that, and then grow from there. You will get better at it, you will get more efficient at it, and you will find marketplaces to make you a lot of money.